problem-solving approach has become a very important element in the social casework process. The reason that there are a lot of problems related to individual and families, and they are increasing day by day. So, as a social workers, it is very essential to understand the problem-solving approaches, its principles and scope. The objectives of this lesson, on completion of this lesson, you should be able to understand the evolution and premise of problem-solving approach, describe the principles and process involved in this approach, and also identify the areas and scope of application. Now, let us understand the evolution of problem-solving approach. It was William James in 1907 who advocated problem solving as a field of inquiry into human problems. Later in 1910, John Dewey described the term reflective thinking. Reflective thinking comprises of four components, namely identifying and formulating a problem, collecting facts that lead to a solution, examining each solution and decide the action to be taken. Use of the term problem solving in the social work context is credited to Perlman, who looked at the use of problem solving extensively in helping individuals in need. Others like Hollis and Hamilton have not given extensive focus on problem solving. Helen Harris Perlman, who developed the problem-solving approach. Social work practice was influenced greatly by the pragmatic approach, which emphasized on the practical usefulness of ideas rather than its absolute truth. Now, this approach believed in the client's capacity for self-determination, which could be used for foster growth and change in the individual. She described the process of casework as a problem solving process where the client is helped to help self by solving and dealing with the problems he or she is confronted with. It should be noted that during that time, social workers predominantly followed the medical model of symptom, diagnosis and treatment. This method of addressing client's problem did not facilitate the client to rely on his or her abilities and learn to help himself or herself for self-growth. Instead, it fostered dependence on some form of outside help. With the introduction of problem-solving approach, there was a shift in the role of social work practitioners as a person who sets things right to that of a collaborator who works with the client and help him or her to be more dependent on self than on professional help to deal with problem solving or problems of living. Problem solving as a therapeutic method of intervention was popularized by Zurilla and Goldfried in the year 1971. As a modern therapy, problem solving therapy is embedded within the traditional psychosocial intervention, which is centered on problem solving skill development in the client. Now, let us understand the concepts and assumptions of problem solving approach. The primary aspect of any casework approach is to help individuals overcome their immediate problems. Hence, element of a problem solving is intrinsic to social casework. Problem solving approach emphasizes on strengthening clients' capacities to deal with life's problems within the context of a helpful relationship. According to Perlman, problem solving work must be a conscious, focused, goal-directed activity between client and caseworker. In problem solving approach, intervention is aimed to correct clients' deficits in problem-solving abilities. Problem-solving must motivate client to mobilize self, to think about self and the problem in an organized and orderly fashion. Problem-solving involves thinking through the facts. The worker also thinks through the facts in his or her mind. The problem-solving approaches also assumes that a human living is in itself a problem-solving process. And process of problem-solving depends on the client's use of his or her perception, understanding, memory, impulse control, and ability to make informed and considered decisions. Adding on to the concepts put forth by Perlman, Halowitz explained the following concepts of the problem-solving approach. The first one is problem-solving work is both tangible and intangible. Tangible problem solving consists of working with those aspects which stand to reason and which are obvious and clear. The intangible work consists of those aspects involved in dealing with intrapsychic conflicts and barriers that affect clients' development. The social worker's problem solving activity has assertive counseling component. This has the following elements. The first one is crisis intervention. Problem solving intervention requires the social worker to work with unforeseen difficulties and chaos in client's life and reduce the negative impact of this on the client. In doing so, the social worker creates a favorable situation which can foster further interventions. The next one is correct the discrepancies between what client perceives as the problem and what is real. The social caseworker helps the client get clarity about the external reality of their client which could have been perceived incorrectly. The third one, work with discrepancies between client's behavior and the goal he or she sets to achieve. The social worker identifies behaviors or problem-solving actions of the client which are impulsive or destructive in nature. The problem-solving work should involve helping the client realize his or her maladaptive behaviors and their undesirable consequences. The next one in under this is taking a position. Now, the social worker should not hesitate to directly express his or her observations to the client and make his or her stand on the issue to enable the client to work on the problem with more clarity. The next aspect is active direction finding. The social worker, through focused questions, provides suggestions the client could think through and discuss the possible directions for finding solutions for his or her problems. The next one is direction implementation. Once the different means of problem solving has been discussed and action plan decided upon, the social worker and client work towards implementing the decision. Working with interpersonal relationship problems can help to clear misunderstandings and false perceptions between individuals. This can then help to come out with more options for problem solving and strengthen the process. Social casework that engages in problem solving work typically involves following the four P's. Person, who is considered as one in constant interaction with his or her internal and external reality and who influences and is influenced by the events in his internal and external environment. The next P is problem. Problem is one that causes distress and discomfort to the person. It could be interpersonal problems or problems related to daily living. The next P or the third P is the place. P Place is considered as the agency to which the client approaches in the pursuit of solution. Function, service and area of concern of the agency fall under this umbrella. The fourth P is the process. Process is the motivating, stimulating and supporting experiences and activities the client engages in with the help of social worker to improve his or her ego functioning and to find solutions to the confronting problems. Compton and Galloway describe the helping process in problem solving as that which includes assessment of motivation, capacities and opportunities to work through the problem. Motivation comprises of hope or discomfort in relation to accomplishment of the solution to the problem. Capacity is explained as the abilities, expertise and information that are required to arrive at finding a solution, and opportunity is described as support and resource the client needs in the problem solving process. Problem solving is a requisite for psychological and social functioning. The social context of the person is important influence in an individual's problems. The social context includes the reality setting of the client and the factors that influence client's life and problems. Dealing with social problems calls for social problem solving, which involve fixing problems that are related to the day-to-day living. The problem solving approach believes that the problem lies in the way in which the client tries to overcome or solve his or her problem. In other words, if the client is unable to find solutions to the problem, it means that the way in which he or she is approaching the problem or solving the problem is not correct. Hence, the client has to be helped to improve his or her problem solving capacity. The problem solving approach considers the client as the problem solver. Medium of intervention is the therapeutic relationship between social worker and client as well as the process of problem solving. It is assumed that this experience of problem solving will not only help client overcome the current problem, but will enable them to equip themselves for dealing with the future problems too. So, after understanding the concepts, the next important aspect to understand in the problem solving approach is the principles of problem solving and the process of problem solving. Now, firstly, we will discuss the principles of problem solving approach. Perlman outlines the principles of problem solving as the following. First principle, a client approaches social work agencies when he or she is not able to find solutions for their psychosocial problems using their current capacities. The second principle, the social work agencies which the client approaches can influence both the help seeking process as well as the client's problems. The third one, relationship between the social worker and the client impacts the problem solving process. Hence, it needs consideration in order to help client overcome the present problem. The fourth one, social worker must gather all facts that contribute to the problem. Fifth one, the therapeutic process has to be organized and specific. This essentially means that the helping process should have a beginning, middle and end stage. The outcome of therapy is dependent on its duration. Hence, the intervention has to be focused and specific. The sixth one is, a problem can be broken into smaller parts which makes it easier for the client and social worker to work on the problem solving process in more efficient manner. As a model, the problem solving model is designed to understand the client's problem, identify and discuss all possible solutions, help client select the best option he or she thinks can solve the current problem, help client implement the chosen solution, and once implemented, evaluate the action taken to see whether the solution was successful in alleviating the problem. The following figure illustrates the stages of problem solving process, which is given by the Perlman. Now, figure 1 is focusing on the stages of problem solving process. Let us now look at the general steps involved in problem solving process. The first aspect of any form of psychotherapy is engaging the client. The social worker establishes a rapport and develops a therapeutic relationship with the client. Identify and define the problem. Once the rapport is established, the social worker discusses the current situation that has prompted him or her to seek the help. In this stage, the problem gets specified and clarified. Now, second stage is to analyze the problem. Client's needs are assessed, client's efforts at solving problems in the past, the client's capabilities and psychosocial barriers in finding solutions, discrepancies between client's realities, perceptions, and expectations are assessed. The problem is explored at length as to why the problem has occurred. Social worker and client discuss complexity of the problem and critically look at all factors associated with the problem. Now, the third step is generate possible solutions. The social worker and client generate all possible options for the problem at hand. In this stage, they address the question what could be done to deal with the problem. Additional facts is gathered during this time if need be. At the end of this stage, the social worker and client generate alternative solutions for the problem. Now, the fourth step is to evaluate the alternative solutions. In this step, the social worker and client critically evaluate the alternatives based on their practicality and completeness. The solutions thus generated are examined and narrowed down to those which are more credible and related to the problem at hand. Once this is done, pros and cons of each of the solutions are discussed extensively. That is, each of the listed alternatives is discussed based on the potential positive and negative effects. Out of the listed solutions or alternatives, the possible solution is chosen by the client with the help of social worker. Now, the fifth step is to implement and assess the solution. The social worker and the client discuss the strategies involved in implementation of the selected solution. Discussions are also based on identifying methods to weigh the effectiveness of the solution. Once there is an understanding over this, the client is encouraged to implement the solution. If required, the client is coached how to implement and practice it with the social worker. Now, after implementation of the solution is revisited and evaluated for its effectiveness. If the solution is found to be ineffective, the possible barriers and challenges in implementation are discussed. If needed, the next best solution from the previously discussed list of alternatives selected and the process of implementation follows. Now, the sixth step is to terminate. The social worker-client relationship is terminated once the client is able to successfully overcome his or her problem for which the agency was contacted. The termination of therapeutic relationship occurs with the understanding that the therapeutic support is available for future if the client wishes to seek help for problems that he or she may not be able to deal with. Problem solving thus involves problem specification, contracting, course of action, discussing the motivations and rationale of the action, examining and overcoming the barriers in implementation, guided practice, review and evaluation of solution and termination after achieving the desired goal. The process of problem solving therapy put forth by Nezu and Zurilla include the following steps. The first step is problem orientation, or how individuals perceive the problem. The second one, problem definition and clarification, in which there is thorough discussion to get a clearer and realistic perception of the specific nature of the problem. Third, generation of alternatives, which involves an exhaustive list of as many alternate solutions as possible. The fourth one, decision making, where all available solutions are evaluated for its possible effectiveness and deciding on the solution to be implemented. Fifth one, solution implementation and verification, involves actively putting the selected solution into action. This requires self-monitoring, assessment and review of outcome. In the first step of this problem solving work, there is a component of motivation, since it is related to the problem orientation or individual's perception of the problem and their inner capabilities of problem solving. Whereas in the later steps, specific skills have to be imparted to the client in order to find an effective solution to the problem. Now let us discuss the scope and application of problem solving. Hallowitz in the year 1979 has divided problem solving situation into 8 categories. He outlines them as the following. The first category is problems related to conflicts and relationship. The second one, problems between a parent and a child. The third one, problems between couples. Fourth, conduct problems in children in the school and also in the home situations. Fifth, problems related to children in conflict with law. Sixth, problems in persons with internalized emotional disturbances. Seventh, problems related to client's environment like family, workplace, etc., which requires invention on behalf of the client. 8, problems related to future planning and decisions. Now let us discuss the criticism against problem solving model. As a practice model, problem solving has raised several concerns. The first concern can be, it is contended that in reality, most of the problems for which clients seek help are complex and are not well defined, as opposed to what is suggested by the problem solving approach. Now, the second is, focusing on problem solving restricts clients from the expressing their life experiences, which could be treated with other forms of therapy. Thus, it does not tap into those aspects which require a different form of intervention. The third, problem solving approach developed in the West, particularly to address the concerns of the white middle class society. Hence, problem solving model is not culture specific and may be not suitable for all the cultures. Fourth, problem solving was originated out of clinical experience with little or no empirical backing. In the modern era, with the emphasis on evidence-based practice, the lack of scientific enquiries on the effectiveness of problem-solving work is one of the major criticisms against this approach. The fifth one is, problem-solving work cannot be considered as a single intervention method and have to be used as a component of a different treatment modality. Sixth one, Problem solving is contraindicated when the client is already in the process of attempting to deal with his or her intrapsychic conflicts. The seventh one, there is always a risk of social worker doing more problem solving than the client does. In other words, there is a risk of the social worker doing the work that client is supposed to do. Now, let us understand the current status of problem solving approach. Problem solving in social work is not a new concept, as every aspect of social work has a component of problem solving. It can be said that as a fundamental concept, problem solving has attracted less attention in modern social work practice. There are very few empirical studies looking into the effectiveness of this approach. As a social work practice, problem solving does not effectively address clients who have a negative problem orientation. Now, let us discuss the summary of the entire lesson of problem solving approach. It is an innovative approach propounded by Helen Harris Perlman, which is inspired by the work of John Dewey. It assumes that problems lies in the manner in which client tries to overcome their problem, and therefore their problem solving capacity has to be enhanced. Therapeutic and professional relationship between the social worker and client and the problem solving process are considered as the means of intervention. The final objective is not just finding effective solution to the current problem, but to enable the client to sustain the skills for future problem solving.